Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Roberts Wesleyan Cheer Squad. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Baller Athletic Center for this evening's East Coast Conference Women's Basketball Championship First Round Contest, featuring the 5th-seeded Bears of New York Institute of Technology and the 4th-seeded Redhawks of Roberts Wesleyan College. At this time, we ask everyone to please rise as we honor America with the playing of the Star Spangled Banner. Now let's meet the starting lineups. First for the Bears of NYIT. Number 5, Shanice Allen. Number 12, Sophia Jirjadi. Number 14, Margaret Nolmeyer. Number 22, Tiara Floss. And number 23, Nina Bukosav-Levedic. The Bears are coached by Mr. Kenny Parham, assisted by Mr. Rob Heil, Mr. Brian Lassner, and Mrs. Dana Carney. Now let's meet the starting lineup for the Redhawks of Roberts Wesleyan College. Number 4, CC James. Number 5, Taya Andrews. Number 11, Emily Miller. Number 12, Brooke Fields. And number 21, Lucy Copley. The Redhawks are coached by Mr. Gary Andrews, assisted by Mr. Jack Rosati, Ms. Marissa Bunce, Ms. Brittany Williams, and Ms. Samantha Courtney. The officials for tonight's matchup are Mr. Rob McDowell, Mr. Reggie Houston, and Mr. Vic Torgiano. Just a reminder, the NCAA East Coast Conference, NYIT, and Roberts Wesleyan College promote a positive game environment and good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request this cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. We do not condone racist, sexist, homophobic, or other discriminatory comments, profanities, or intimidating action on the basis of one's appearance, identity, perceived identity, or for any other reason directed at officials, spectators, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives. Any of these actions will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Also, consumption or possession of alcoholic beverages and use of tobacco products are expressly prohibited. Be loud, be proud, be positive. The winner of tonight's contest will advance to take on top-seeded Queens College in a semifinal matchup of the East Coast Conference Championship Women's Basketball Tournament on Saturday, March 4th at noon on the campus of the University of Bridgeport. Be sure to check eccsports.org for all tournament details. Fouls on number 21, Lucy Cogley, her first personal, first team foul. Fields her first personal, second team foul. Substitution for Roberts Wesleyan for 13, Kinsey Brandt.
So here we are at the Baller Athletic Center. We have a little bit of a late start here. The Roberts Wesleyan women's basketball team, they're playing the NYIT Bears, who happen to be seated in the tall seat, Roberts Wesleyan is seated fourth. Right now there's 8:40 left in the first quarter. The Bears are already up 7-0. Nothing, a little over 8 years left to play in the first quarter. No good. Rebound by Brookfield. She passes it up to Tay Andrews, who passes it off to Kinsey Brandt. She picks it up, and there's the first basket for Robert Wesleyan College.
Kinsey Brandt.
That makes it 9-2 with 7:40 left here to play.
So Tiara Place just hit her first foul shot. Here she goes for a second. She hits her second. So that gives the Bears a 7-point lead, makes it 10-3. With 7:30 left here to play in the first quarter. So Brookfield's with the ball. She penetrates on the left-hand side. Can't get it. She tries to go for the offensive rebound. Can't get it. It's in the hands of the Bears on the breakaway in transition. Pass up to Tiara Pace. Can't get it. Pass back out to Shanice Allen. Off the rim. Emily Miller, she tries to save it, but it goes out of bounds.
Substitution for Roberts Wesleyan.
So substitution for Roberts Wesleyan, it's going to be number 22, Taylor Bino. So Vukla Sankovic passes it in to her teammate, Shanice Allen. And pass it around the arc. And pass it back up to Sophia Dutrati. Vukla Sankovic put it up for the three-pointer. Was no good. Out of bounds. Roberts Wesleyan ball. So Sarah Nady is going to be checking in for the Redhawks. So Sarah Nady with the ball on the left-hand side for the Redhawks. She picks up her dribble. She passes it in to her teammate, Morgan Patton. She goes on the right-hand side, can't get it to fall. So Vuka Sankovic passes it off to Georgiati. In the corner, the shot's put up. No good, ball's out of bounds. Sarah Nady trying to save it. It's going to stay here, Redhawks ball. There's going to be a kickball called on the inbounds pass. There's a nice easy pass on Georgiati. She lays it in. Oh, excuse me, that was for Margaret Nolmeyer. So it extends the Bears' lead to 11. So it's 13-2. Bears are on top with 6:10 left here to play. Kinsey Brandt tries to drive on the right-hand side. Doesn't fall. The Bears are pressing again. And Vukla Sankovic pulls it back out. Tries to slow it down. Pass it around the arc. Pass it down low to Nolmeyer. Passes back up. Place tried to drive on the left-hand side. Couldn't get it to go. So Sarah Nady has the ball for Redhawks. She's driving on the right-hand side. And there's going to be a blocking foul called. Foul's going to be on Shanice Allen for the Bears. It's going to be her first personal, team second. Number 11, Emily Miller checked in for the Redhawks. Okay, so the lane's cleared out. Sarah Nady passes out to her teammate. Emily Miller can't get it to fall. Excuse me, that's Lucy Cobley. And a basket for her. It's her first basket on the day. So it's a second basket. Roberts Wesleyan, 13-4, with 5:26 left here to play. Bears with the ball. Vukla Sankovic tried to pass it down low to one of her forwards and pass it right out of bounds.
Substitution for NYIT number 3,
Caleb Bomani checks in for the Bears. So Nady passes it to Emily Miller, who passes it out to Lucy Coley. And there's going to be a foul called on the rebound.
Foul number 12, Sophia Giorgiati, her first personal, third team.
Foul's going to be on Sophia Giorgiati, her first personal, team third. So long pass into Emily Miller for the Redhawks, but the ball turned over into the hands of Caleb Bomani. She passes it over to her teammate, and she lays it in for an easy layup. Basket was by Margaret Nolmeyer. So she has 6 points on the day, extends the lead to 11 points. So 4:50 left here to play. Redhawks with the ball. Sarah Nady trying to drive on the right hand side. She gets called for the foul. So it looks like there's going to be a timeout here by Roberts Wesleyan. So we're going to have a media timeout here. We're going to step aside. We'll be back after the timeout. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Basketball here on RWCSN.
The East Coast Conference is committed to excellence both on and off the field. Member institutions are active in supporting their communities through service and fundraising projects, and our student athletes work hard to achieve in the classroom, preparing themselves for success after graduation. The ECC, home to 21 national championship teams, currently provides 17 championships in 10 sports and is committed to creating a positive game environment for all. The East Coast Conference, a proud member of
Bill Gray's is serving up fresh food that's made to order and just...
So we're back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the Roberts Wesleyan Women's Basketball game against NYIT Bears. So right now we're here in the first quarter. There's 4:49 left to play. The Bears have come out to a lead quick. It's 15-4. They lead. And so for those of you who are just tuning in, NYIT, they're ranked fifth in the conference, and Roberts Wesleyan, they're ranked fourth. So the last game between these two, it was actually back on the 18th, and the Redhawks won. They won 88-85, so it was a good game. So it's always usually a good matchup between these two. Whoever wins this game today goes on to the semifinals, which we played at Bridgeport on March 4th against number one ranked Queens College, who actually happened to win the conference the past 2 years. So we'll see what happens here today. So right now, the Bears have the ball. Passed out. The three-pointer by Bamani was no good. Rebounded by Kinsey Brandt for the Redhawks. She passes down to Lucy Cove, who passes it back to Kinsey Brandt. Hits the rim for the three-pointer. Hands up Amani. Back up to Nolmeyer, who tries to pass it down to Georgiotti, but it's taken away by Nene. Nice hustle right there on that play. So Lucy Kobley put up a long three-pointer. It was no good. Rebounded by Vukosagovic. Georgiotti passes it over to Place. Passes it in to Nolmeyer. Passes it back out to the arc. So 10 seconds on the shot clock. Pass it down to the forward. On the right-hand side, Georgiotti places it in for another basket. That's 4 points for her. So that extends the lead 17-6. 3:35 left here to play in the first quarter. So Serenade picks up her dribble for the Redhawks. Passes it over to Brooke Fields. And she dribbles in the middle. Turns around. Tries to put it up. No good. Tries to get her own rebound. And the Bears come away with it. Sokovic has the ball on the right-hand side, the left-hand side. Pass it over to Georgiotti, who passes it over to Place. Place gets the ball back on the right-hand side, tries to lob it into her forward. And Georgiotti lays it in for another easy basket. That's 6 points for her on the day, so 19-6. Bears on top, 2:53 left here to play. Nady picks up her dribble, passes it over to Tay Andrews, who passes it in the corner to Kinsey Brandt, drives on the baseline, puts it up, has two defenders on her, and it's knocked out of bounds. It's going to stay here.
Substitution for NYIT, number 5, Shanice Allen.
Shanice Allen's going to check back in the game for the Bears. So Kinsey Brandt, the inbounds passer for the Redhawks, passes it in to Sarah Nady. She drives into the paint, puts it up, off the backboard, doesn't get it to roll. So Bears push the ball up. Kinsey Brandt almost got her hand on that for a turnover. Nolmeyer put up a long three, no good. Got the offensive rebound, and a foul is going to be called on the putback. Foul's going to be on Sarah Nady, her first personal, team fourth.
Foul 20, say so, Nady, her first personal, fourth team.
So that's going to send Tiara Plays to the free throw line to shoot free throws. She's going to get two shots. She hits her first. Emily Miller checks back in the game for the Redhawks.
Substitution for Roberts Wesleyan, number 11, Emily Miller.
So Place's second shot, hits the top of the rim. So the score is 26 with 2:20 left here to play. Bears on top, and there's a turnover. To Vukosavljevic, gets the pass, and she lays it in on the right-hand side for an easy basket. So she has 4 points on the day. The lead is now extended 22-6 with just over 2 minutes left here to play in the first quarter. So Roberts is really going to have to get something going here if they want to keep it in the game and keep it close. Emily Miller passed up to Kinsey Brandt, who tries to pass it up. Lucy Coveley gets it back, recovers. Sarah Nady drives in the paint. Three-pointer by Kinsey Brandt is no good. But Sarah Nady gets it back. Shot clock is reset at 25. She pulls up again and shoots another three-pointer. Can't get that one to fall. Rebound Bears. They push the ball up the floor. Minute and a half left here to play. And there's going to be a foul called on the Redhawks. So Caleb Amani is at the line for the Bears to shoot free throws. She misses her first shot. CeCe James is checking in for the Redhawks.
Substitution to Roberts Wesleyan, number 4, CeCe James, and number 22, Taylor Bynoe.
Taylor Bynoe is also checking in for the Redhawks. Bomani hits her second shot. So it's 23-6 with 1:26 left here to play in the first quarter. So Brooke Fields is bringing the ball up the court. Pass it off to Bino, pass it back to Fields, and she hits the three-pointer. All right. So 23-9 now. Bears still on top. Minute 9 left here to play. So Allen with the ball. Pass it to Georgiotti. Pass it to Vukosavljevic. Nohlmeyer tried to put it in for a basket, but it hit the rim. So CeCe James now with the ball for the Redhawks. Passes it off to Morgan Patton. And she's going to get a foul drawn. So foul is going to be called to number 12, Sophia Georgiotti. That's her second personal, team fifth. So Taylor Bino is going to be going to the line to shoot. She misses her first.
Substitution for NYIT.
So Taya Andrews checking back into the game for the Redhawks.
Roberts Wesleyan, number 5, Taya Andrews.
And Madison Stripoli is checking in for the Bears. So 51.4 seconds left in the game. So Vukosavljevic is pushing the ball up the floor. The Bears pass it over to her teammate, who passes it back out. Vukosavljevic gets the ball back. She's looking at passing into one of her forwards, who gets double teamed. Tries to bank it in off the backboard. It's no good. Rebound by Emily Miller. Passes it off to CeCe James. 30 seconds left here on the scoreboard. Loose ball, but CeCe James maintains it. About 3 seconds left. Or 3 seconds in between the scoreboard and the shot clock. There's a timeout, there's a whistle by the ref. He was checking with Vukosavljevic to see if there was something, if she was okay. Okay, so Redhawks still with the ball, 15 seconds left. They're gonna run the clock down, see if they can get one less basket here. She goes left-hand side around the defender and banks it off the backboard. So 23-12, 4 seconds left here. Let's see if they can get one last shot off. Allen puts it up, no good, and there's the buzzer. So a little bit of a slow start here in the first quarter for Roberts Wesleyan Redhawks. At the end of the first quarter, the score is 23-12. NYIT Bears are on top. So we'll be back here for the start of the second quarter between the two. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Basketball here on RWCSN.
Sports have evolved over the years. Back then, our helmets were leather. Not everyone was encouraged to play. We only drank what they gave us. Our socks were high and our shorts were short. Our masks were terrifying. We wore fur. We searched for an edge. Sometimes that meant stick 'em. Other times that meant voodoo. We went big, really big. It was business up front and party in the back. And we didn't have a nutrition plan.
That was then. This is now. Athletes have evolved. We are today's athletes. We are focused. We push ourselves further. We're all players now. We have no offseason. We demand better, and we're obsessed with what we put in our bodies. Sports have evolved. So has the sports drink. Upgrade your game. Upgrade to body armor.
We're back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the Roberts Wesleyan Women's ECC game against the NYIT Bears. For the start of the second, the Bears are on top 23-12. And Roberts has the ball. Brookfield has a nice pass in on the left-hand side to Taya Andrews and lays it in for an easy bucket. So 23-14. Cuts the lead down to 9. Snowmeyer passes it over to Plays, who tries to lob it into one of her forwards. And the ball goes out of bounds, so it's going to be a turnover. Roberts Wesleyan ball. So 9:30 left here to play in the second quarter. Redhawks are down by 9. Currently with the ball in their possession. And CeCe James is going to be called for a travel. Passing to Pomani. That was Shanice Allen. And pass over to Vukosakovic. Gets it over to Pomani on the right-hand side. Shanice Allen comes back. She pulls up for the jumper, and she misses. Ball is out of bounds, and it's going to go the other way. CeCe James passes it off to Tay Andrews, who passes it off to Emily Miller. Shot's no good. Georgiotti passes it off to the point guard, who gets it back. Passes it over on the right-hand side to Shanice Allen. Passes it off to Pomani. She's looking for some to see what she can do. Picks up her dribble. Passes it back to Vukosakovic. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Vukosakovic pulls up at the free throw, no good on the shot. Emily will at the rebound. So CeCe James pushing the ball up the floor. Pass up to Tate Andrews, who pulls up for a quick shot, and she sinks it for a three-pointer. So that cuts the lead to 6. So the Redhawks seem pretty flat in the first quarter, but they are coming out here quick. Let the Bears know that they're still in the game. But there's an easy lay-in by the Bears. It's good. That basket by Shanice Allen. And they go the other way. So it's Emily Miller with the easy basket on the right-hand side. So Redhawks with the full court press. So the ball is back up top. Vukosakovic is calling the play. Sit there, goes right in the middle, gets the ball turned over. Tay Andrews with the breakaway, no one in sight. And she lays it on the right-hand side. So that cuts the lead to 4. That's the closest lead since probably the start of the game. And it's going to be a timeout by the Bears.
This is a 30-second timeout.
It's going to be a 30-second timeout, so we'll keep you here for a moment.
Correction, this is a media timeout.
Actually, there's going to be a change on that. It's going to be a media timeout. So we'll step aside. We'll come back after the timeout. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Basketball here on RWCSN.
Every day there is a decision. One that can, of course, change the course of this destination we call our future. Decisions come from moments. And in those moments at Roberts Wesleyan College, we acknowledge a vision that works out to a better way to be living. But what if I told you there's a decision? And I made one, you see? Because I came to Roberts Wesleyan College, I found a better me.
Bill Gray's is serving up fresh food that's made to order and just for you. Voted Rochester's best burger and fish fry, we're the hometown favorite that will make you say,
"Gimme, gimme, gimme Bill Gray's."
So we're back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the Roberts Wesleyan women's basketball game against the NYIT Bears. There's 7.5 minutes here to play in the second quarter. The Redhawks are currently trailing by four. It's 25-21. And the Bears currently have possession. Vukosavić passes it off to her teammate, puts it up for a three. It's no good. It's rebounded by Taya Andrews. Taya Andrews passes over to Brookfield, who tries to pass over to her teammate, Emily Miller, but it's turned over right in the hands of Vukosavić. It's the point guard who's pushing the ball up the floor. She dribbles right. Pass it off to Place, who tries to put it up, and she's stripped, and ball's out of bounds. It's going to go the other way. So CeCe James picks up her dribble, passes it off to Tay Andrews. She dribbles in the paint. She passes it back out to Emily Miller, but she is also going to get called for a travel. So the ball's going to go the other way. So a couple of possessions here right in a row where there's been a couple turnovers. So Vukosavić gets the ball. She pushes the ball all the way up. Tries to pass off to Nolmeyer, but the ball goes out of bounds. Ball's going to go the other way. Red Hawks ball. So 6:35 left here to play in the second quarter. Redhawks are still trailing by four, 25-21. Emily Miller passes it off to Lucy Coveley, passing into the corner to CeCe James. She drives on the baseline, tries to go on the reverse layup, no good. It's rebounded by Margaret Nolmeyer. So Vukosavić goes to baseline, she puts it up, and the basket's going to go in, and she's also going to get called for a foul.
Count the basket.
Foul's going to be on CeCe James. Going to be her first personal team first as well. So Kinsey Brandt's also going to check back in for the Redhawks. So Vukosavić is at the line to shoot for the Bears. She hits her shot, so that's going to make that a three-point play. Extend the lead back to seven for the Bears. CeCe James passing off to Tay Andrews, dribbles on the right-hand side, takes it all the way, and banks it in right off the backboard. So that gives her 9 points on the day, Tay Andrews. So Georgiani passes it off to her teammate, and they're going to be called for an offensive foul on the Bears. That foul is going to be on Sophia Giorgiotti for the Bears.
Offensive foul number 12.
That's going to be her third personal, team first.
Team foul.
So Tay Andrews drives on the right-hand side. She passes it back out to Lucy Coveley, passes it off to CeCe James. Gives it to Tay Andrews. CeCe James gets it back in the corner. She dribbles in the paint. Passes it off to Kinsey Brandt. Seven left on the shot clock. They're going to have to do something quick here. Gives it to CeCe. 3 seconds. Shot put up by Tay Andrews. No good. And a foul called on the rebound.
Foul number 5, Shanice Allen, her second personal, second team foul.
Foul's going to be on Shanice Allen. It's going to be her second personal, team second as well. So Kinsey Brandt's going to be going to the line to shoot. She misses her first.
Substitution for Roberts Wesleyan,
number 20, Sarah Nady. Kinsey Brandt sinks her second shot, so that cuts the lead to 4. So it's 28-24, 5:17 left here to play. Roberts was in with a full court press on the Bears. So Shanice Allen pulls it up on the, pass it up on the right hand side, pass up to her teammate, shot put up, no good, but they do get it back. Shanice Allen tries to put it up again, no good. There's loose ball, and Roberts was in finally comes away with it. So Sarah Nady passes it up to Taya Andrews, takes a look. She decides no. Emily Miller drives on the baseline, puts it up, and she draws the foul on her. It's going to be a 1-1. Foul's going to be on Margaret Nolmeyer. It's going to be her first personal, team third. So Emily Miller's at the line. So between the first and second quarter so far with what we've seen, and the Roberts Wesleyan team looks like a completely different team. They were pretty flat in the first quarter. They weren't really calling any plays. They weren't working together, and now it seems like the complete opposite. So they've been able to cut the lead to 4. So the shot is missed by Emily Miller. So Bears with the ball. Vukasakovic has it. Puts up a long 3, and she drains it. Does what she is known to do. So she has 10 points on the day, extends the lead back to 7. It's 31-24, 4:25 left here to play in the second quarter. So Tate Andrews gets it down low, passes over to Emily Miller, pulls out for the short jumper. And it goes in. Her second bucket on the day, 4 points, cuts the lead to 5. So Bears now with the ball back. Pass over to Shanice Allen. Pass it over to Place. Passes it back to Kelly. And gives it back to the point. And Shanice Allen pulls up for the short jumper for 2. So 33-26. Lead back to 7. 3:45 left here to play in the second quarter. So Sarah Nady on the left-hand side. And Lucy Colby with a long 3. So cuts the lead down to 4. She has 5 points on the day. Her next point is going to be her 1,000th career point here at Roberts Wesleyan College. So that will be very, very nice to see for her. So Tiara Place put a shot up there, but she got fouled. So she's going to be going to the line to shoot free throws for the Bear. Foul's going to be at number 5, Tay Andrews. It's going to be her second personal, team second as well. She hits her first.
Substitution for NYIT, number 31, Madison Schipoli.
So, substitution for the Bears, Madison Schipoli. And Taylor Bino is going to check back in for the Redhawks. So, Place hits her second. So, that makes it 35-29. Bears on top, leading the Redhawks. 3:14 left here to play in the second quarter. So Coveley passes it off to Bino, who passes it off to Lucy Coveley, who she tries to go in the middle, but she's met by 2 defenders. So Vukasakovic tries to go through 2 defenders. She does, gets the basket and the foul, showing her speed right there. She loves to take the ball end to end in transition and get those fouls drawn on her and get those easy baskets. So Brooke Fields checks back into the game for the Redhawks. The shot is missed, so no 3-point play there. So the lead stays at 8. And there's going to be a whistle by the ref. Seems like there was some kind of issue with the scoreboard not starting. And so the time of the scoreboard is going to be 2:54. And there's going to be 24 seconds on the shot clock. So Redhawks with the ball. Sarah Coley passes it over to Emily Miller, who gets a rebound and puts it right back in on the left-hand side. So nice put back for her. So cuts the lead to 6. Emily Miller has 6 points on the day. So the score is now 37-31, 2.5 minutes left to play. So pass back up to Shanice Allen, pass it over to Vukasagovic, who she puts it up for another 3. She is on fire tonight. So she hits another 3. That gives her 13 points and extends the lead to 9, 40-31. So, and there's going to be a foul called on Vukasagovic for the Bears.
Foul number 23.
That's going to be her second personal, team fourth. So Serenity gets the ball on the inbounds pass. She dribbles on the right-hand side, spin move baseline, and she lays it in. So both teams getting a lot of baskets down low today. So 40-33, Bears still on top. Shot put up by Nohmeyer, no good. Emily Miller saves it, gives it off to her teammate, Brooke Fields. She dribbles up the floor, picks up her dribble right in the paint, but she's going to get called for a travel. And Brooke Fields very upset with herself why she did that. So 1:52 left here to play in the second quarter, 40-33, NYIT Bears on top. They've been leading for most of the game. So a long pass in to Nohmeyer, she lays it in, and another basket for the Bears. She has, Nohmeyer's 8 points on the day, extends the lead to 9. Brooke Fields with the ball, passes it out to Taylor. Pass it out to Taylor Bino for that last basket. So Shanice Allen with the ball for the Bears. She passes it over to Nohmeyer. Passes it over to Place. She drives on the left-hand side and finds another easy lay-in. So she has 7 points on the day, and the lead's up to 11. But unfortunately, that's not the biggest lead that the Bears have had in the game. So under a minute left here to play. Serenity gets the ball for... puts it up, no good on the 3. So 46 seconds left here in the second quarter. Bears with the ball. Let's see what they do here on maybe one of their last possessions of the half. Vukasagovic pulls up again. She misses left. And there's going to be a 30-second timeout called by the Redhawks.
Roberts Wesleyan, this is a 30-second timeout.
So we'll keep you here for a moment during the timeout. For those of you who are just tuning in, for whoever wins today's game is going to play number 1 seeded Queens. This is, of course, for the ECC Conference on March 4th at Bridgeport for the semifinals. Today there's also a game between a number 3 seeded St. Thomas Aquinas and number 6 seeded Bridgeport. And whoever wins that game will go on the 4th, and they'll play number 2 seeded Beloit. So Queens College, of course, they've won the conference for the past years, for 2016-2015. The Roberts Wesleyan Redhawks, actually last year, they were the runners-up, and they only lost by 6. So they're trying to fight back here today so they can continue on. So we'll see what happens, if they can pull something here. So 30 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Serenity with the ball for the Redhawks. About 6 seconds between the shot clock and the scoreboard clock. Serenity's going to run it down. She's going to wait. So she's on the move. Passes it over to Brooke Fields. There's 5 seconds left on the shot clock. She pulls up. She gives it to Tay Andrews. And it's going to be a shot clock violation. Waited just a little bit too long there.
Shot clock violation, NYIT ball.
So Kinsey Brandt checks back into the game for the Redhawks. There's going to be 5.2 seconds left on the scoreboard. Vukasavic waits to pick it up. She pushes up the floor as quick as possible. Tries to pass it off with three. No good at the end. So going into halftime, the Redhawks are trailing the NYIT Bears 36-44. We will be back after halftime with some of first half stats, and we'll see how the rest of the game goes. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Women's Basketball here on RWCSN. So we're back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the Roberts Wesleyan women's basketball game against the NYIT Bears. This is the first round in the ECC championship bracket against the number 5 NYIT Bears, of course. So for the start of the third quarter here, the Bears are leading the Redhawks 44-36. So just a quick go over here, a couple of the first half stats. The shooting for both teams was pretty even. The Bears were did a little bit better. They were 42.5% from the field compared to the Redhawks 37.8%. The Bears shot 66.7% from the free throw line compared to the Redhawks 50%. They're pretty even on the boards. They were pretty even as far as and turnovers and steals and things like that. So pretty much the Bears, they've just been able to kind of finish their plays, get the bucket, and come out 8 points on, up top. But Emily Miller, she just went ahead and she scored an easy basket on the right-hand side to cut the lead to 6. So it's 44-38, Bears on top. Pass it to Nolmeyer. She puts it around, no good, can't get the basket to fall. Pass into Brookfield, who passes it over to Lucy Coveley, and she puts it in. And that is her 1,001 point for her career here at Roberts Wesleyan College. So congratulations to her. That's quite an accomplishment. So Georgiotti just had put in another basket for the Bears, so she had an easy layup on the right-hand side. She has 8 points on the day, so keeps the lead to 6, 46-40. Emily Miller just missed an easy basket on the right-hand side. Not sure what happened there. But long three-pointer put up by the Bears. Nolmeyer got the offensive rebound, and she's fouled. So foul's going to be on number 21, Lucy Coveley. It's going to be her second personal, team first. So Nolmeyer's at the line to shoot. She misses her first shot. And she misses her second as well. So Emily Miller rebounds it for the Redhawks. So the score stays 46-40 with a little over 8 minutes left here to play in the third quarter. So Fields passes it off to Tay Andrews, who passes it off to Lucy Coveley, who passes it out to Emily Miller. She pulls up. No good on the shot. Savlovic rebounds it. Pass it up to her teammate, and she is going to be fouled by Lucy Coveley.
Foul number 21, Lucy Coveley, her third personal.
That's going to be her third personal, team second. So Shanice Allen at the line, shoot two. She misses her first. Allen hits her second, so it extends the lead to 7. She has 8 points on the day. So it's 47-40, 7:46 left here to play. CeCe James for the Redhawks with the ball. She dribbles on the left-hand side, passes it over to Emily Miller, who tries to give a screen to Brooke Fields, who she dribbles back to the left and pulls it back out. She's looking for some movement from her teammates, passes it over to Taya Andrews, who dribbles into the paint, passes it, dishes it to Emily Miller, back to Taya Andrews. She puts it up, and she sinks it. So 11 points for her, cuts a lead to 5, 47-42, Bears still on top. So Southlevik passes it on the right-hand side, down in the corner, teammate with the ball, dribbles into the paint. Plays couldn't get it to fall, and Tay Andrews comes away with the ball for the Redhawks. So Tay Andrews dribbles on the right-hand side, picks up her dribble, passes it out to Lucy Coveley, and misses. Georgiotti comes away with the ball. She passes over to the right-hand side to her teammate, and she sinks it. That basket was by Shanice Allen. That was a three-pointer, so extends the lead to 8, 50-42. Bears still on top. Cece James drives on the left-hand side, and she gets called for the foul, so she's going to go to the line and shoot two shots. Foul's going to be on Nina Soplovic. It's going to be her third personal team first. So Soplovic has been the hot hand for the Bears today. She had 15 points at the half. So she definitely wants to play it easy on defense. And I'm sure the Bears wouldn't want to see her foul out. She's usually a three-point shooter, and she's their point guard as well, and she makes a lot of baskets in transition, so it'd be a shame to see her out. So Cece James hits her second shot, cuts the lead to 7, 50-43. Bears still on top, so pass down in the corner to Allen. She pulls up, misses short. Tay Andrews comes away with the rebound. Pass it over to Cece James. Pass it back to Tay Andrews, fakes the look, passes it down to Emily Miller. Pass it back up to Tay Andrews. Cece James dribbles in the paint, dribbles on the right, tries to put it up, and no good. Ball goes out of bounds, and it's going to stay with the Redhawks. So 5:59 left on the clock. It's 50-43, Bears leading the Redhawks. And the refs are going to confer about something here. Cece James passes it in to Lucy Coveley, who gives it back to her in the corner. 7 on the shot clock. Cece James dribbles in the paint, spin move. Tries to bounce off the backboard, just quite can't get the ball, but she does get it back, and the shot clock is reset. Tay Andrews puts up the shot, bounces out, no good. Place with the, Georgiotti had that rebound. Passes down to the forwards, no good. So no basket for the Bears. Cece James with the ball again for the Redhawks. Pass it over to Tay Andrews, gives it right back to her. Pass it to Emily Miller in the corner. Cece James for the long three, misses short, and she gets a rebound. So shot clock's reset, passing the ball around the arc. She calmly passes it over to Tay Andrews, and she misses as well. To fight for the ball. And it is going to stay with the Redhawks. So Taylor Bino comes back in for the Redhawks. Sarah Nady's also checking back in for the Redhawks.
Substitution for NYIT number 31, Madison Stripoli.
Madison Stripoli checks in for the Bears. So a couple of substitutions here. So 5:02 left on the clock. Redhawks are trailing by 7, 50-43. And it looks like there was some kind of interference on the play. There looks like there was a child that hit the inbounds passer. So take two on that. So Kinsey Brand tried to pass into Emily Miller, but she was just swarmed by Bears defenders. So Soplovic tries again to take it all the way and isn't called with the foul. Some people wanted a travel call for Sarah Nady, and she's trying to push the ball up the floor. Kinsey Brand tried to push it, trying to get a layup down low. Coach Gary Andrews absolutely wanted a foul on that, but that's a no-go, no call. And Tiara Place is able to take it all the way, gets a lay-in for the Bears. She has 9 points on the day, so the lead is at 9, 52-43, 4:26 left here to play. Emily Miller drives into the paint, dishes to her teammate. And Taylor Bino gets it to fall.
Taylor Bino.
So she has 6 points on the day. So now it's 52-45. Redhawks are still trailing. So Allen with the ball up top. 11 left on the shot clock. Being guarded tightly by Sarah Nady. Soplovic comes over to help her. Gives her the screen. Dribbles through two defenders. Tries to pass through a teammate. But nice hustle by Taylor Bino. It's able to get the ball for the Redhawks. So Taylor Andrews with the bounce pass. Emily Miller can't quite finish that play. That would have been a nice play if the girls could finish that. She doesn't quite get the roll, so Sablui comes away with it. Passes it off to her teammate, Shanice Allen. She dribbles left. Kinsey Brandt is guarding Sablui tightly. And there's going to be a foul called. Foul's going to be called on Sarah Nady. It's going to be her third personal, team third as well. And it looks like there's going to be a timeout called here. It's going
to
be a media timeout, so we'll step aside for a second. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Basketball here on RWCSN.
The East Coast Conference is committed to excellence both on and off the field. Member institutions are active in supporting their communities through service and fundraising projects, and our student athletes work hard to achieve in the classroom, preparing themselves for success after graduation. The ECC, home to 21 national championship teams, currently provides 17 championships in 10 sports and is committed to creating a positive game environment for all. The East Coast Conference, a proud member of NCAA Division II.
And we're back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the Roberts Wesleyan women's basketball game against the NYIT Bears. There's 3:19 left here to play in the third quarter, and the Redhawks are trailing the Bears 45-52. So possessions with the Bears. Sablovic puts up a long three. She misses. But Shanice Allen comes away with it for the Bears. So they're going to get another chance. Shot clock is reset. So Place tries to put it in. No good. And another offensive rebound. Place tries to take it all the way in the paint. Can't get it to fall. And a fourth attempt. And just throwing the ball up there. And there's going to be a foul call. Redhawks really need to box out there so they don't keep giving three and four chances.
So maybe her fourth personal, fourth team.
So that's going to be Sarah Nady's fourth personal foul, and it's going to be the fourth team. So she's going to go sit down for a minute. Brooke Fields checked back in for the Redhawks. Sablovic passed it in to Shanice Allen. Basket's going to be no good, but yet another foul is going to be called. Foul's going to be on Brooke Fields, her second personal. Team fifth. So Shanice Allen's at the line. She gets the first one to roll in. So it extends the lead to 8, 53-45. And she hits her second as well. So it extends the lead to 9. That gives Allen 13 points on the day for the Bears. So 2:45 left here to play. Redhawks are trailing by 9, but they have the possession, and there's going to be a foul called away from the ball.
Foul number 22, Tierra Place.
Foul's going to be in a 22, Tierra Place for the Bears. It's going to be her first personal, team second. So Lucy Kogan missed on the three there, but Sablovic pushing the ball up the floor, dishes to her teammate for the three. Can't quite get it to fall. Taylor Bynum comes away with the rebound. Passes it off to Brooke Fields. Who passed down in the corner to Kinsey Brandt, who drives on the baseline. And there's going to be a foul called on her. Foul's going to be on Shanice Allen. It's going to be her third personal, team third. So play gets reset back with Brooke Fields up top. Dribbles left. Picks up her dribble looking for help. Finds Tay Andrews. And long shot for the three, no good by Fields. And Taylor Bino comes away with it. And Lucy Cobley again, couldn't hit on the three. Sablovic pushing the ball up the floor. She pulls it back out, and she finds her teammate wide open and lays it in on the right-hand side. That basket was by Margaret Nolmeyer. And a nice give and go. 2 points for Lucy Coveley. Nice pass from her teammate as well. She has 9 points on the day. So the lead is still at 9, 56-47 Bears, with 1:30 left here to play in the third quarter. So a long pass over to Shanice Allen. Passes it into her teammate. But the Bears get another shot at it. Tara Place had the offensive rebound there. And a turnaround jumper by Margaret Nollmeyer. So the Bears using their forwards frequently tonight. And it seems to be very effective. Had a lot of passes down low and a lot of little short jumpers, and it seems to be effective. So less than a minute left here to play in the third quarter. The shot's put up by Shanice Allen by the Bears. No good. Bino passes it up to Taya Andrews. She passes it down in the court to Kinsey Brain, who drives baseline. She puts the shot up, and she was just a little bit too far under the hoop. So no good. So under 30 seconds left here to play. Bears push the ball off the floor. Place with the ball. She picks up her dribble, passes it over to Allen. About a second separating the shot clock and the scoreboard clock. Georgiotti puts it up. No good. Nollmeyer got it. She couldn't put it up either. And on the third attempt, there's going to be a foul called. Foul's going to be on Taylor Bino, her first personal team.
Foul 22, Taylor Bino, her first personal team.
It's going to be the team six. It's going to be one shot for Tiara Place. No, excuse me, for Sophia Georgiotti. And she does hit it. So I do apologize, she's gonna actually get two shots here. And she hits her second as well. So that extends the lead to 13. Sit there, 9 seconds left. Let's see if the Redhawks get one more shot off. CeCe James, spin moves in the paint. Can't get it. Sablovy comes away with the rebound. She's going to have to put it up. And she can't get there quite yet. So at the end of the third quarter, the NYIT Bears are leading the Roberts Wesleyan Redhawks 60-47. We'll be back here at the start of the fourth quarter to see how the game finishes out. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Basketball here on RWCSN.
Sports have evolved over the years. Back then, our helmets were leather. Not everyone was encouraged to play. We only drank what they gave us. Our socks were high and our shorts were short. Our masks were terrifying. We wore fur. We searched for an edge. Sometimes that meant stick'em. Other times, that meant voodoo. We went big, really big. It was business up front and party in the back. And we didn't have a nutrition plan.
That was then. This is now. Athletes have evolved. We are today's athlete. We are focused. We push ourselves further. We're all players now. We have no offseason. We demand better, and we're obsessed with what we put in our bodies. Sports have evolved. So has the sports drink.
So we're back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the start of the fourth quarter for the Roberts Wesleyan women's basketball game against the NYIT Bears. The Redhawks are currently trailing by 13 points. It's 47-60. And just because it's worth mentioning again, one of the Redhawks players, Lucy Coveley, she's a junior guard out of Fairport, New York. The last quarter, she scored 1,000 points. She actually has 1,001 now. It's an amazing accomplishment, so congratulations to her. So Redhawks with the ball here. CeCe James drives in the paint. She puts it up on the right-hand side, and she gets it to roll. So 5 points for her on the day. Cuts the lead to 11. Sablovic's pushing the ball up the floor for the Bears. So Place passes it over to Savlovic. He's up at the top, beyond the arc, tries to get the screen from her teammate. She pulls up her jumper, and she sinks it. She makes that look so effortless. She has 15 points on the day for Savlovic. So Tay Andrews pulls up for a three-pointer, and she drains it. She answers. So she has 14 points on the day, cuts the lead to 10. Place gets the ball inbounds for the Bears. Bomani dribbles all the way, and she's going to be called for a traveling violation. So it's going to be a turnover, Red Hawks ball. So Shanice Allen and Margaret Nohmeyer, check back in for the Bears. So the Bears still holding a 10-point lead on the Red Hawks. 8:45 left here to play in the game. Red Hawks possession. So let's see if they can what they can get going here. So Tay Andrews dribbles. She dishes it out. Emily Miller puts it up for the three. No good. Georgiotti with the rebound. So Savlovic calling to play. Pass it over to Georgiotti. Pass it to the right-hand side. We pass it to Bomani. She dishes it down to her forward. And Georgiotti lays in the left-hand side for 2 points. So leads back to 12. 8:10 left here to play in the game. Emily Miller picks her dribble up down low. Passes it out to Tay Andrews. Pass over to the right-hand side to Kinsey Brandt. Being guarded very closely by Savlovic. And they say it's going to go the other way. So Pomani bringing the ball up. The Red Hawks pass it over to Savlovic. Pass it over to Georgiotti. Pass it over to Allen. Pass it to Pomani. Dribbles once, picks up her pass. Allen gets the ball in the corner. Pulls up, tries to bank it off a little bit too hard. Red Hawks get the rebound. CeCe James brings it up on the left-hand side. Dishes it to Kinsey Brandt. Fakes the shot, puts it up, and misses right. Allen with the rebound for the Bears. Passes it into the corner to Bomani for a long three-pointer. She misses long as well. Tay Andrews almost gets the ball taken away from one of the defenders coming up behind her. So CeCe James tries to find an open lane on the right-hand side and just misses on the roll. But she does get it back. Passes it out to Tay Andrews, puts it up for a shot, and she drains it. Very nice shot there by Tay Andrews. 17 points on the day for her. She's playing, looking very confident in her play today. So Bears get the ball back. First shot's no good. Georgiotti tried to put that up. They're going to say it's a jump ball and it's going to stay with the Bears. So it's 64-55, 6:42 left here in the fourth quarter. Tierra Place checks back in for the Bears. Sarah Nady comes back in for the Red Hawks. Sarah Nady does have 4 personal fouls, so she's going to have to be careful here on defense. So Place tried to put up a jumper at the free throw line, but it was no good. Sarah Nady pushing the ball up the floor. So the paint is completely cleared out. She passes it out back out to CeCe James. Serenity comes around, tries to put it up, misses, but with the putback by Emily Miller. Nothing like your teammate getting your putback for you. So Shanice Allen drives on the right-hand side for the Bears, and they answer. So 66-57. Bears still leading. Just over 6 minutes left here to play in the game. Bears have been leading for a majority of the game since the start. Tay Andrews passed right into the Bears defender. Savlovic had a breakaway, but she's going to get called for a foul. Foul is going to be on Tay Andrews. It's going to be her third personal, team first. And Brookfields is going to check back into the game for the Red Hawks.
Third personal. First team foul.
So we're going to say Sal Levique stepped out of bounds, and so it's going to go the other way. Oh no, excuse me, that was actually a foul on Sal Levique. That's got to be her fourth personal. It was an offensive foul. So CeCe James with the ball. Pass over to Tay Andrews, and there's going to be another foul called. That foul is going to be on Sophia Giorgiotti. It's going to be her fourth personal, team second. So there's a couple Bears players right now who have four fouls on them, so we'll see if that affects how they play defense at all. Tay Andrews dishes it to her teammate Emily Miller, and who is almost allowed to go right through and lay it in. Definitely don't want one of their players, so one of their star players to foul out. So the lead is cut to 7, 66-59 Bears. To lob into Margaret Nomeyer, no good. Redhawks come away with the ball. Crowd really starting to get into it here. They sense the momentum shifting. Tay Andrews picks up her dribble, but there's a turnover in the paint. She tried to pass off to Emily Miller, no good. And Tiara Place is able to get a basket in transition for the Bears. So lead is put back to 9, 68-59 Bears. Fields with a long three, misses short, hits the rim. Emily Miller tries to get it, but no good. Sablavi comes away with it. Passes it over to Allen, who passes it over to Giorgiotti. Pass it into Place, who lobs it into Nolmeyer. Nolmeyer passes it back out. Place goes baseline, and another offensive foul call. You don't see that too much. So ball's going to go the other way. That was on Tiara Place. That's going to be her second personal, team third. There's going to be a timeout called here. It's going to be a media timeout, so we'll step aside. We'll be back after the timeout. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Basketball here on RWCSN.
Every day there is a decision. One that can, of course, change the course of this destination we call our future. Decisions come from moments. And in those moments at Roberts Wesleyan College, we acknowledge a vision that works out to a better way to be living. But what does better look like? Any counselor can discuss the mind-numbing effects of depression, but I have a confession. A better counselor can look past the message and give a lost soul direction. Any nurse can scan and study an EKG, but a better nurse is one that can break the chains of a patient's anxiety. Any businessman can learn the secret to increase revenue, but a better one is giving back to spur a community to pull through. Any educator can teach to pass a test, but a better one is those challenging the struggling without neglecting the rest. Any lawyer can process the papers to finalize a foreclosure, but a better one is finding the solution to help the client to start over. Any doctor can fill out a prescription, but a better one helps their patients see beyond their affliction. Any athlete is driven by competition, but a better one encourages no matter their position. Any pastor can plan a church event, but a better one reminds their church that God...
We're back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the Roberts Wesleyan Women's Game. There's 4:28 left to play in the game. They're playing the NYIT Bears. The score is currently 68-59. The Redhawks have been trailing for most of the game. The largest lead in the first quarter was 16 points, but they're able to pull it back to 10 currently. We'll see if they can get something going here. So there's going to be a foul called on Tay Andrews. Foul's going to be a Margaret Nolmeyer. That's going to be her second personal, team fourth. So CeCe James gets the pass in to Lucy Coveley. Pass it into Brookfield, who dribbles in the paint. She puts it up and misses left. But Emily Miller gets it to fall and the foul called on her. Foul is going to be on Sophia Giorgiotti. That is going to be her fifth, so she is going to foul out.
She is fouled out of the game.
So she definitely wasn't happy about that call. Understandably, she wanted to be in the game. She said she was standing straight up. But we'll see how that affects how the Bears play defense. And we'll see if the Redhawks can capitalize with her being out of the game now. Georgiadi does finish the game with 12 points.
Substitution for NYIT, number 31, Madison Tripoli.
So Madison Tripoli is going to check back in place of Georgiadi, and we'll see if Emily Miller can hit her shots here. And she does. So lead is cut to 6, 68-62, just over 4 minutes left here to play in the game. And there's almost a turnover, but Tripoli manages to keep it in check. Place passes it over to her teammate, who does lay it in on the left-hand side. Basket was by Millmeyer. So lead is back to 8. Tate pulls up for a 3, and she drains it. So 20-point game for her. Cuts the lead to 5. Redhawks with a full-court press here, trying to put some real pressure on the Bears, see if they can get them to make some mistakes. Plays with the ball. Tries to lay it in. And there's going to be a foul called on the rebound. And refs are pointing. It's going to go the other way. Foul's going to be a number Tiara Place. That's going to be her third personal. Team fifth. So there's going to be 2 shots here for Lucy Coveley. The Redhawks are now in the bonus. And she does hit her shot, so cuts the lead to 4. Making it a close game here. And she easily sinks her second. So one possession game here, 3-point game. 70-67, Bears still leading. 3.5 minutes left here to play. The crowd chanting defense, really getting into the game here, sensing the shift in momentum. So Allen with the ball, dribbles in the paint, shot is called off, and the foul was on the floor.
Foul on the floor, number 4, CC.
Foul's going to be in CC James, going to be your second personal, team second. Savlevic passes it into place. And there's going to be a foul called on the Redhawks. It's going to be a pushing foul. So Allen with the ball up top. Finds Savlevic in the corner. She passes it back, gives it to Place. Passes it to Nolmeyer. Savlevic with the ball again. Pass it to Nolmeyer. Tries to put it up, and she's met with 2 defenders, but the refs say it's going to stay here with the Bears. So 3:02 on the clock. 3-point game. Bears leading the Redhawks, 70-67. They've been leading since pretty much the tip-off. So Place at the free throw line, puts it up. Looks like there's a tip on it, but Nolmeyer came over and got the offensive rebound. 4 on the shot clock, shot is put up, can't get the roll, but Place gets her shot back again and puts it up, and there's a foul called.
Foul number 11, Emily Miller, her first personal.
Foul's going to be an Emily Miller, her first personal, team fourth. So it's going to send Tiara Place to the free throw line. Lockout. So she misses her first shot, keeps it a 1-possession game. The last contest between these two, Roberts Wesleyan only won by 3 points. So it usually is a close game between these two teams. So the refs are conferring with the scoring table about something. And It looks like we're ready here for our second shot. So place does sink her second shot. Lead is now 4, 71-67. 2:47 left here to play. CeCe James dishes it out to Emily Miller, who misses short. Brooke Fields did try to get the offensive rebound, couldn't quite come away with it. Allen passes it over to Place. Pass it back up to Cipolli, passes it over to Sablovic. Passes it out to Allen. It was a hand in the face by Tate Andrews, pass it to her teammate. Tried to lob it into Cipolli, but it's knocked out of bounds. It's going to stay here with the Bears. James, ball down in the corner on the left-hand side. She dribbles into the paint, passes out to Tay Andrews. Gives it back to CeCe James, being guarded tightly by Sablovic. Pass it into Emily Miller, can't quite bank it in off the backboard. So no basket for the Redhawks, they really could have used one. So just over 2 minutes left here to play. Still a four-point game, Bears on top. They've been leading for majority of the game. Their biggest lead was 16, but the Redhawks been able to cut it down to 4. Cipolli for the turnaround jumper in the paint. So that extends the lead to 6 with 1:46 left here to play. So the Roberts are really going to have to hopefully look for a three-pointer here. Tay Andrews does. Hits the rim. No good. So Sablovic passes it over to Place. Pass it over to Nohmeyer. Sablovic pass over to Cipolli. Puts up a long three-pointer. Misses. CeCe James gets the rebound. Brooke Fields puts up a long three. Can't quite get it to fall. Cipolli gets the board, and it's going to be a jump ball. And it's going to stay here. CeCe James finds Lucy Coveley, puts up a long three-pointer. No good. Tay Andrews tries to save it, but it does go out of bounds. So 1:02 left here to play in the game, 73-67. Two-possession game.
Substitutions for Roberts Wesleyan, number 13, Kinsey Brandt, number 22.
So Kinsey Brandt and Taylor Bino check back in for the Redhawks. And there's going to be a foul called on Taylor Bino. It's going to be pushing. It's going to be her second personal. Team fifth. It's a team limit, so Allen's going to be going to the line to shoot. So she hits her first shot.
Substitutions for Roberts Wesleyan,
so
number 5.
Lucy Coveley and Tay Andrews check back into the game for the Redhawks. And she hits her second. So that makes it an 8-point game, 75-67, with exactly a minute left to play in the game. There's going to be a timeout called here by the Redhawks. So we'll go ahead and we'll step aside for a moment. We'll be back after the timeout. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Women's Basketball here on RWCSN.
Honey, I made you lunch.
That's my mom. Same lunch every day. Well, that's perfect lunch.
Saboteurs.com. Philgraze is serving up fresh food that's made to order and just for you. Voted Rochester's best burger and fish fry, we're the hometown favorite that will make you say,
Gimme, Philgraze!
So we're back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the Roberts Wesleyan women's basketball game. There's a minute exactly left to play in the game against NYIT Bears. Redhawks are down by 8, 75-67. Possession is theirs. Emily Miller puts a long three-pointer up. Can't quite get the roll, but she comes back in, gets the offensive rebound. There's a loose ball, and it's going to go out of bounds and stay here. 46.7 seconds left on the scoreboard. So pass into Lucy Coveley. Passes it over to Brookfield. Puts the shot up. Basket and the foul.
Count the basket.
So that cuts the lead to 6. And Field is also going to be going to the line to shoot. Foul was on Shanice Allen. That's her fourth personal, team fifth. Misses the shot, so no three-point play. Allen comes away with it for the Bears. She's pushing the ball up for CeCe James. Tried to foul her. And passed down to Nohmeyer. Passed it over to Stripoli. Passes it out to Place. And there's a timeout called by the Bears. So we'll keep you here for a moment during the timeout. So it's a six-point game. The biggest lead by the Bears, it was 22-6 in the first quarter. When the Redhawks, they came out, they started very flat. They just seemed like they weren't quite in the game, but they were able to pull back to make the closest a four-point game at some points. But it just seems like they weren't able to just get a few rolls on the basket. They weren't able to stop the Bears in transition. Sablovic for the Bears, she was able to get a lot of easy lanes in transition, and it's translated over onto the scoreboard. So whoever wins this game, who at the moment it looks like it's going to be the Bears, is going to go on at the fourth, and they're going to play number one seeded Queens at Bridgeport for the semifinals. And after that, the winner of that game would go on to the finals for the ECC Bracket Championship. So Nohmeyer gets the ball inbounds, but she's going to be fouled.
Foul number 11, Emily Miller.
Foul's going to be an Emily Miller. It's her second personal. So she is going to be going to the line to shoot. She does make her shots. That makes it a seven-point game, 76-69. Taya Andrews comes back in for the Redhawks. And Lucy Coveley also checks back in for the Redhawks. And she hits her second shot as well. So that extends the lead to 8. The Redhawks call a timeout. We'll step aside for this timeout. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Basketball here on RWCSN.
Every day there is a decision. One that can, of course, change the course of this destination we call our future. Decisions come from moments. And in those moments at Roberts Wesleyan College, we acknowledge a vision that works out to a better way to be living. But what if I told you there's a decision? And I made one, you see? Because I came to Roberts Wesleyan College, I found a better me.
Back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the end of the Roberts Wesleyan women's basketball game against the NYIT Bears. 29.7 seconds left on the clock. 77-69. Bears are on top. Redhawks possession. And the pass into Emily Miller. Who's being guarded very tightly by the defender. Pass over to CeCe James for a three-pointer. Misses right. And the foul is going to be called on Emily Miller for the Redhawks. That's her third personal. The team has hit their limit for fouls, so there's going to be some more free throw shots here. Nohmeyer's at the line for the Bears. Easily sinks her shot again.
Substitution for Roberts Wesleyan, number 20, Saiso Nady.
Sarah Nady checks back in for the Redhawks. She misses a second shot. Taye Andrews gets the rebound. It is going to be a timeout call by Redhawks head coach Gary Andrews.
This is a full timeout.
And it's going to be a full timeout. So we'll go ahead and we'll step aside again. We'll be back after the timeout. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Basketball here at RWCSN.
East Coast Conference is committed to excellence both on and off the field. Member institutions are active in supporting their communities through service and fundraising projects, and our student athletes work hard to achieve in the classroom, preparing themselves for success after graduation. The ECC, home to 21 national championship teams, currently provides 17 championships in 10 sports and is committed to creating a positive game environment for all.
So we're back here at the Baller Athletic Center for the Roberts Wesleyan Women's Basketball game against the NYIT Bears. 21 seconds exactly left in the fourth quarter. Redhawks possession. So we'll see what the Redhawks can figure out here for their last possession of the game. Taye Andrews gets the shot. Has to kind of throw it up there. No good. Just a jump ball on the floor. A couple bodies ended up on the floor there. And the refs are pointing that it's going to go the other way. There's going to be a foul on Kinsey Brandt. Her second personal. And again, because the team has hit their limit, the Bears are going to be going in the free throw line. Noel Meyer hits her shots. She's been very effective at the free throw line. She's helped herself and her team out a lot. Shot does roll in, so that extends the lead to 11. 15.3 seconds left. Sarah Nady pushing the ball off the floor for the Redhawks. Passes it over to Lucy Coveley, who her defender got a hand on it. So the shot didn't quite go up. Sal Levick has the ball for the Bears, and they're just going to run the timeout. So final score for the Roberts Wesleyan women's basketball game against the NYIT Bears. The Bears come away with the win, 80-69. So 11-point loss. Last game between these two, it was a 3-point loss. So that does knock the Redhawks out of the ECC championship bracket. But hopefully we'll have a short interview here for Gary Andrews, head coach of the Roberts Wesleyan College. And hopefully we'll be back in a moment with that. You're watching Roberts Wesleyan Basketball here on RWCSN.
Every day there is a decision. One that can, of course, change the course of this destination we call our future. Decisions come from moments. And in those moments at Roberts Wesleyan College, we acknowledge a vision that works out to a better way to be living. But what does better look like? Any counselor can discuss the mind-numbing effects of depression, but I have a confession. A better counselor can look past the message, give a lost soul direction. Any nurse can scan and study an EKG, but a better nurse is one that can break the chains of a patient's anxiety. Any businessman can learn the secret to increase revenue, but a better one is giving back to spur a community to pull through. Any educator can teach to pass a test, but a better one is those challenging the struggling without neglecting the rest. Any lawyer can process the papers to finalize a foreclosure, but a better one is finding the solution to help the client to start over. Any doctor can fill out a prescription, but a better one helps their patients see beyond their affliction. Any athlete is driven by competition, but a better one encourages no matter their position. Any pastor can plan a church event,
We're here back at the Baller Athletic Center with Roberts Wesleyan Women's Basketball Head Coach Carrie Andrews. So, Coach, you guys came into this game. Of course, you played the NYIT Bears with very similar records. The Bears, they were 16-10. You guys were 17-11. The last game against these guys on the 25th, on the 18th, you guys won by 3 points, so it's usually a close game. So the first half, biggest lead at one point, it was 22-6. Was there something? Did the girls just come out and they just play flat? And do you think that contributed to, you know, just a big lead to overcome for the game? What kind of happened?
Oh, I mean, the start killed us. I mean, we weren't ready to go. And, you know, some of our girls that have been there before, you know, have had the conference tournament experience, you know, didn't play as well as they're capable. And that, you know, that really, really hurt us. I mean, you know, we didn't shoot well, but we didn't execute like we should. You know, part of our trouble, we have people that are worried about, you know, they're worried about scoring points. They were selfish and, you know, didn't run our plays like we're supposed to, and it hurt us. And that, you know, that's kind of been our problem all year. You know, some of our older kids got to play a little more mature, a little more unselfish, and it really cost us.
Absolutely. So, of course, the loss, it does knock you out of the ECC championship bracket. The NYIT Bears are going on to play number one seed at Queens on the 4th. What are some of the highlights that you saw from this season? Some players that you saw have some really big growth, or maybe some good games, or any kind of things that you can highlight throughout the season?
I mean, I thought Lucy Coveley really, you know, improved to be an all-around player. I mean, she rebounded. She became a good post defender. I mean, she scored her 1,000th point tonight. You know, that's a great honor.
Absolutely.
You know, I thought she did really well. You know, I thought our freshmen, they're going to be really, really good. I mean, even tonight, they're the ones that, you know, kind of kept us in the game. I mean, Tay and Emily, you know, Emily missed some easy ones, but, you know, Emily also battled and, you know, got some rebounds for us. And, you know, it's hard to rely on freshmen. We needed our older kids to step up, and they struggled tonight. And, you know, they're good kids, and, you know, hopefully they can bounce back for the Christians. But, you know, that's kind of, we needed them to step up tonight, and they didn't do it, unfortunately. And then NYT's, their older kids stepped up, and their experienced kids, and, you know, that's why they won, and we're going home.
Absolutely. Well, you guys had a great season. I know you have a couple other games coming up, so hopefully, you know, we'll play those games a little bit better. But as always, thank you for a couple minutes of your time.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.